What's up, SnowTrax viewers? Luke here. I got a 2022 Yamaha walk around video for you guys today. And we just got these things in directly from Yamaha. These are limited build models, so nobody else has seen them. We have to keep them covered right now whenever they're outside, so no one else can see them, but you're gonna get to know about them pretty soon here. So once that happens, this video will be posted and everyone will know what I know. But anyway, I digress. Let's move on. This is an LTX, a Sidewinder L-TX LE. There's a lot of different letter denominations from Yamaha over this next season. And one interesting thing is that none of their sleds have the LE, SE, GT writing on them. They only say LTX, so you have to know based on the color or the features which one it is. So this is an LE. This is the top of the line LTX model. Below it you have a GT that's more designed for kind of touring, and then an SE that is sort of the base, more base model, but it's still pretty well appointed. Anyway, this is a 136. It has the sliding rear suspension. It has a, let me see, get this right, a 1.25 Ripsaw II track, again in a 137 length. This is a performance trail model. That's what this is. This is basically one level below, say, an SRX. Sort of the most high performance model from Yamaha that isn't an SRX. So that's kind of interesting. Some changes, some things about this sled that may or may not be different from last year, but are interesting and things to note. You've got, instead of IQS, which this model had last year, the electronic three-position suspension, this year you have FOX QS3-R 1.5 Kashima-coated front shocks, a QS3 1.5 Kashima-coated center shock, and a QS3-R 2.0 rear shock. So basically what that means, the R designates rebound. So these shocks have your three position compression up here and then a rebound adjuster down here. And I think that this is the very best setup for QS3s that you can get. They're Kashima coated, so they're basically stiction free. And having that rebound adjustability, a lot of people don't understand rebound, but once you do understand it, it has a huge effect on how your suspension works. So having that adjustability on the front shocks and the rear arm shock is excellent. It's huge, and especially for this kind of buyer. This sled comes with sort of this mid-height painted windshield. The color scheme, you only get one color scheme in the LE trim, and it's this silver blue, which I think is very nice looking. I really like it. Trail seat, Yamaha's trail seat is good, but it's a little on the short side. And we've said this for quite a while now. We've said it many times, so I don't feel like flogging a dead horse, but with just a couple inches, maybe an inch and a half more padding, this would be a lot more comfortable. But it's not bad, it's not unlivable by any stretch of the imagination, and this is actually a very comfortable sled to sit on and ride all day. Ergonomically, very comfortable. Again, handlebars are in a good position, all your switch gears easy to reach. I will say that this thing has a fantastic brake. This Hayes brake, master lever and lever, is among the best in the business. Lever feels awesome on your fingers, and the modulation and power of it is fantastic. So that's really good for a sled that has arguably in the neighborhood of 180 to 190 horsepower. Yamaha claims 180 horsepower of the Genesis 998 triple, but interestingly Arctic Cat claims 200. Yes, they are the same motor. There are some tuning and clutching differences and things like that, but if one's claiming 180 and one's claiming 200, then I'm just going to average it and say 190. So let's just call it 190. With that said, having a great brake is important when you've got a motor that makes 190 horsepower. This vehicle has a heated seat. It has an included heated visor outlet, as well as a tether, which is interesting. Also up in the dashboard here, you have a 12 volt outlet up by the gauge, and you have push button start and push button reverse, same button. So you can start it with the key, but you can also simply push the start button and it'll start. So there's multiple ways to start this sled. Basically for the cockpit, that's about it. This thing has an aluminum gas cap on it. Sometimes Yamaha likes to throw on some accessories for us. I don't think this is factory. I don't think this comes on all models, but it's pretty cool and it's in their accessory catalog. So, you know, something to think about if you want a Christmas present from your wife. Other notable features about this sled is the new strike ski. I guess it's not new. It was on our models from this year. The Strike single keel ski. This ski is really good. It makes these Yamaha sleds handle fantastic. It bites good in the snow. It doesn't dart overly bad, no worse than any other ski on the market. It's a good looking ski, but just an absolute awesome ski for these vehicles in light of the skis that they've had in the past. And we're just so happy that it's here. This vehicle does have a full width 42 inch trail front end. I mentioned the shocks already. This bumper is included, and I just got to mention something about the bumper. When you look at the front of this sled with the bumper included, it's really interesting how you have a multi-level kind of nose on it. You got this panel here that's actually raised on both ends for airflow, and then you've got this level here. You've got these side pieces with a recessed here, and then you've got your grill intake down here as well. I think the nose of this sled just has a really cool look. I really like how it looks. It just looks really aggressive and mean up front. They always have. I like these big air scoops. You know, we talked about style. Style's subjective. It's you like it or you don't. You're not wrong or right, but I do like how this sled looks a lot. I also like the color matching between the windshield, the riser, the skis, you know, your rails, your bumper, all those things. Color matching with the rest of the sled looks really, really clean and really classy. Track is a 125. That's a good track for a sled like this. Good mix of speed and traction. You get this 20 inch tunnel bag included, which is nice because that's, you know, other than your little goggle storage thing up here, they call that a goggle storage container. I don't know if my goggles would fit in there, but you can put something in your balaclava when you stop for lunch and it keeps it warm. That's sweet. But that's the only storage option you get on the sled. So other than that, there's not really much to say. This sled rides really well, especially with those Kashima coated QS3Rs. I really like how this sled rides. I like how it handles too. The more time I spend on these Sidewinders with the higher end suspension and the new ski, the more I'm coming to terms with, you know, trail riding and being able to be really fast on them and being comfortable with how they handle. It doesn't take long to get used to it. And I definitely think this is one of the best front ends in the business. So that's, you know, that's good. And of course you got arguably 190 horsepower under the hood. So this sled is an animal if you want it to be. But one of the really nice things about the Genesis Triple in this configuration with the turbo is that it's also super controllable. So I have actually let my wife ride this sled, and you know, she's not an aggressive rider by any stretch of the imagination. She was fine. It didn't scare her. It didn't go too far. It didn't do anything abrupt or overpower her. She could ride it really smooth at lower throttle settings, lower throttle inputs, and it was great for her. So that's an interesting one. I wouldn't necessarily suggest you give this sled to a novice, of course, but for somebody who doesn't want an abrupt, overly jerky sled in terms of power, this is a great option because this motor is buttery smooth. Basically, I think that's it for this sled. There's not really much else to say. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please click the like button. Please leave us some comments, whether you liked it or not. Let us know. Let us know if there's anything we can do different, if there's anything you want to hear more of or see more of. And if you haven't already, make sure you click that subscribe button, because we are updating content on our YouTube page sometimes more than once a day right now. This is a busy time of year for us with new models and new information and all kinds of exciting new stuff. So if you want to be updated on all that stuff as it comes out, definitely click that like and subscribe button, and you'll get notified as soon as new stuff is uploaded. So on that note, I've run out of things to say, and I'm a Lester, so that means something. It means it's time for the video to be over. Again, thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.